Unlike other royalty companies that might be segmented or siloed into silver, gold, or platinum metal groups, we look at a variety of assets and projects in a variety of spaces. Resources, we like resources a lot, but that doesn't necessarily mean we don't invest in other projects.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Thomas Sauvé. He is the CEO of Royalty Management Holdings. And Thomas, good to see you. How are you?
No, it's good to see you as well. I'm great. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, good to have you along. I know you put out some news about one of your portfolio companies. We'll talk about that in just a second. But first, for those not familiar, maybe give me a bit of background on Royalty Management.
Sure. Royalty Management Holding Corporation is a public company on the Nasdaq. Our mission is to invest in projects and assets that and primarily in the resource space, that we can invest in that project, get an ongoing royalty interest in, and kind of that's how we make money, get the project off the ground, and get them kind of going.
Yeah. Do you look at a lot of different types of companies? You mentioned resource companies, but are you looking at a lot of different metals, a lot of different things, or do you sort of stick to one area?
So that's a good question. So unlike other royalty companies that might be segmented or siloed into silver, gold, or platinum metal groups, we look at a variety of assets and projects in a variety of spaces. Resources, we like resources a lot, but that doesn't necessarily mean we don't invest in other projects. For example, we have an investment in a company that captures water and gets drinkable and potable water for industrial uses. And we work with that company as well.
Okay. Now the news you had out was from TR Mining. Tell me a bit about TR Mining and they're in the rare elements game.
They are now. So basically TR Mining was it's a Jamaican company that we partnered with early on. And when we did the initial assessment, we saw that it had a very attractive concentration of elements, vanadium, titanium, and iron ore, which is used in magnetite. Now these are used in everything between pigments to medical uses to aerospace. But the question that we had is whether or not there's other things beyond what we initially tested for. So we worked with the Jamaican government to get another test going, and it turns out that we have other elements that are very attractive as well, particularly rare earth elements, which are used in more defense and aerospace related things.
Yeah. So you're now you were working with the company, helping them. You have a 10% royalty on there, so about getting permits and all that. So obviously there's some big steps forward this company's about to take.
Yeah. So where we go from here is we have a special exclusive permitting license within a 25 square mile of essentially the coastline within Jamaica to be able to take and turn that into a mining license, so we can kind of take the sand that's there and be able to concentrate it in order to a sellable form that we can get these elements out.
Yeah. And so that will take place over the next 3 to 6 months type thing. Is it that type of work, or is this long-term?
Our goal is, yes. Our goal is to wrap up that permit later this year so that we can start production next year and start concentrating these elements and start selling the rare earth elements.
Okay. We've obviously seen some turnaround in the markets as far as prices are concerned and all that. Where you sit now with your portfolio, are you pretty excited about the next 3, 6 months to a year or so, Thomas, with what you have in your portfolio now?
Yeah, absolutely. So basically, as I mentioned earlier, we are looking at a lot of resources and we do a lot of different types. We're not siloed. But one thing that we're particularly excited about is that because of the recent attention on rare earth elements, we have been formulating a complete supply chain of being able to get the resource to concentration to refining of rare earth elements and metals throughout that whole supply chain. And we've been working on that for the past several months to sort of create that which is not within the United States currently, but created within the United States.
Yeah. And lastly, are you looking at adding more companies within the portfolio as well? I mean, it sounds like you've had a lot of growth already. Do you anticipate more of that in the future?
So great question. We are always looking for good ideas. We have a contact information on our website that if somebody has a resource or an investment idea or a project that they're looking to get off the ground, we're always looking for great ideas and we look forward to kind of reviewing them. We look at, as I said originally, a variety of resources, a variety of assets. So if we're not siloed, we're looking forward to kind of reviewing a lot of different opportunities.
Absolutely. Well, Thomas, congratulations on TR Mining. I look forward to following their story as it continues to develop. And great to see you as well. We'll talk again soon, okay?
Very much appreciate it. Great talking to you as well.
All right. There's Thomas Sauvé. He is the CEO of Royalty Management Holdings.